In this screencast, we're going to work through the approach to a mass transfer problem, specifically one in which we have a reaction occurring at a surface. So here we have a thin film of metal, which we're calling species C, and it's being deposited onto a silicon wafer by the instantaneous reaction that's given below. We want to come up with an equation which could be solved to predict the mole fraction of A as a function of Z. So if you look at our reaction, we have 2A in a gaseous state, and it's fluxing through this gas layer down to the surface, along with B, also in a gaseous state. And these two react to form C and 4D, and D is a gas, and it's fluxing away from the surface. So we've said that the surface is our Z equals zero, and the top of our gas layer is some delta for our thickness, and our mole fraction of A is some known concentration of A, which we're designating as YA naught. Based on this, we can see that since we have a flux of both A and B through the gas layer to the surface and a flux of D away from the surface, we're looking for an equation for the flux of A to give us our concentration of A. We're going to look at both the diffusive and convective terms to characterize this flux. So we'll start by writing out our flux equations, and we start with the continuity equation for species A. We have dCA dt plus the divergence of the flux of A, or del dot NA, and this is equal to our reaction term RA. So the question is this a steady state process? Do we have anything changing with time? Now at the startup or shutdown of this process, we would have unsteady state conditions, and thus the concentration of A would be a function of time. However, if we're assuming that this process has begun and there's no limit to A and B being fed to the surface, C is a thin film such that the gas layer thickness is not changing significantly, we could assume this is steady state and cross out this first term. Now for our divergence term, we're examining the system in the Z direction only. So we're going to write this as dNA as a function of Z. So dNA dZ. Now we set this equal to our reaction term. However, the reaction term is zero, since we do not have a reaction occurring within the diffusional path of A. This is important. The reaction term, this RA, is on a per volume basis within the control volume. Now in this case, our control volume is this space, this gas layer, which we're looking at. And so since the reaction is not occurring within that control volume where we're examining the flux, this reaction term is zero. So when we go through these terms, what we're left with is that the flux of A in the Z direction is not changing. So from here, we'll use Fick's law to describe the flux of A in terms of the diffusion of A and the bulk flow of A. So when we write out Fick's law for the flux of A in the Z direction, we get negative concentration times the diffusivity of A through B, dy, dz. This is the diffusive part. The bulk flow or convective part is the mole fraction YA times the flux of A plus the flux of B plus the flux of D. Now we don't consider C because that's a solid layer and it is not fluxing. Now our first simplification to this is going to be to write the fluxes in terms of the flux of A. Now let's look at B and A. We know that 2A react per each B molecule. So since we have twice as much A reacting with 1B, we need the flux of A to be twice as fast as the flux of B. So this means that the flux of B is going to be equal to half the flux of A. When we compare A and D, we see that for every 2A fluxing to the surface, we have 4D fluxing away. Thus, the flux of D with respect to A will be twice that of A and in the opposite direction. So 2NA is equal to negative ND. So we're going to write the flux of ND in the Z direction as negative 2NA. So now we could plug these into our Fick's law equation. and simplify this, and you can see because this is non-zero, we do have a bulk flow component, and therefore do have both diffusive flux and a convective flux of A through this gas layer. So what we're going to do is bring this term over to the left side, and we're going to group the flux of A in the Z direction together. And now we could bring this term back over, and we have a relationship for the flux of A in the Z direction. Now, this isn't quite what we're looking for, so we're going to combine the continuity and Fick's law to come up with the following relationship. We know the differential of the flux of A in the Z direction with respect to Z is equal to zero. So we're going to take Fick's law and take the derivative of it with respect to Z. So to approach this and combining them, we could take a first look at the continuity equation. And since the flux of A with respect to Z is equal to zero, we could say that the flux of A in the Z direction must be constant. And we'll call this NaZ naught. And so now we know that Fick's law, the flux of Z must be equal to NaZ naught at every position of Z. So we could set this equal to negative C dAB dy dz over 1 plus yA over 2. Now if we're going to solve for yA as a function of z, we need to rearrange terms and integrate using boundary conditions we know. Now the boundary conditions are that at z equals 0, we have an instantaneous reaction, so yA is going to be equal to 0, whereas z equals delta, we know yA is equal to yA naught. So if our end goal is to get an equation for yA as a function of z, we first need to solve for NaZ naught. And we can solve for NaZ naught using the boundary conditions. So what we're going to do is separate our variables and write this as NaZ naught dz, evaluate this from 0, z equals 0, to z equals delta, and set this equal to negative C dAB, since these are constants, times the integral from 0 to yA naught. And this is going to be dyA over 1 plus yA over 2. So now evaluating the left side, we get NaZ naught times delta, and evaluating the right side, we get 2 times the natural log of 1 plus yA over 2. So now to solve for NaZ naught, we just divide by delta, and we get the following equation for NaZ naught. So lastly, we could put this back into our equation to solve for y as a function of z. If we set these equal, simplify, and rearrange terms, you should get the following. However, this time we're evaluating from 0 to z, and therefore 0 to yA. So solving these integrals and simplifying, we get the following relationship, where we could figure out the concentration or mole fraction yA as a function of z.